So now we're ready to talk about vector spaces. And the reason why we talk about vector spaces is that vector spaces have a very special property that a few vectors can describe an infinite number of vectors in that space. For our purposes, a vector space is just a subset S of the set of all vectors with n components. But this set has some very special properties. First of all, the zero vector must be an S. Second, if you are given two vectors that are in S and you add them together, then you end up back in S. Third, if you have an element in R, in other words, if you have a real number and you have a vector in this set S, then if you multiply that vector by alpha, then you end up back in that set. Mathematicians would say that S is closed under addition and scalar multiplication. If you go to Wikipedia and you look up what a vector space is, you get a much more complicated explanation than this. We're simply focusing on the part that you need to know for this course. Now, it is the case that a little bit later in the course, we are going to very briefly talk about complex valued vectors. And all of this carries over to the case where the vectors are complex valued. So, some examples that we've seen before. The set Rn is a vector space. 0 is in Rn. If you're given two vectors in Rn and you add them together, then you get another vector in Rn. And if you're given a vector in Rn and a scalar, and then you multiply that scalar times that vector, then you simply get another vector with n components, so it's in Rn. We'll see many examples of subspaces in the remainder of this course. If you want to know more about vector spaces and more complex settings in which vector spaces come up, go and look at Wikipedia.